Hi, it's Tony Barrett from Venice, California. This piece, I call it Documentary Venice Beach Music Fest 6. My style is documentary styles. A lot of folks say, well, your stuff is really, really long, man, but I shoot documentary style. That's what I do. This piece is an incredible piece. It's probably one of my favorite pieces. So it's an incredible piece. Celebrities, Venice Beach at its best. I'm really proud of this piece. And you're going to be really surprised in the band that we have big celebrities playing in this. I hope you enjoy it. Here's the video.
Are we all good there? All right. Hi, everybody. We're the Broken Numbers Band. Glad to see you all here. And to see the ocean. That's kind of nice. Dancing's encouraged. Here we go.
Yeah.
stop us and cut it down.
My passport. Oh, this shit ain't on my passport. Yeah. I gotta cut it all off.
Oh, that's gonna be strange.
Be different, that's all. We had to get used to seeing me like this for a while anyway. I might keep it like that.
Wow.
Yeah, who knows?
Since 1984.
And there's rumors that you're moving.
Well, I love Venice, but when you love a place, you can always come back because your heart will always be in Venice. But I want to go to Australia because Australians love my work, and I want to go spread some love and also sing jazz, blues, reggae. I want to go put a band and travel to Australia, New Zealand, Thailand, and maybe come back after 6 months to America.
Back to Venice?
Yeah, back to Venice, for sure.
And you have any kids?
Yes, I have one daughter in New York. She's an artist as well.
And her name?
Judith Joseph.
And your website?
JeanPaulArt.com.
Spell it.
JeanPaulArt.com.
Costa Rica?
Yeah, that's where I met this man. I was in a place called Cahuita, beautiful place.
And you like birds?
Oh yeah, I do, definitely.
Why you like birds so much?
Because they are the spirit of God. They bring you news when it's gonna rain, when a hurricane is coming.
What's your favorite piece?
Out of all my work?
Yes.
A place called City by the Bay. There it is.
And why is this your favorite piece?
Because the colors are so vibrant, maritime colors.
And this is where?
That's in a place called Jacmel. It's close to Cuba.
You see, you were there?
Yeah, between Haiti and Cuba. Beautiful place.
And
What does this piece run?
About $1,500.
Wow, man, that's cheap.
Reasonable.
Very reasonable, man.
Because I want people to have my art.
That's beautiful. And sir, your final words.
Yes, thank you very much. My final word is my dream is to bring fresh, clean water to the Haitian people. So when children go to the source to get water, they can drink clean water so they don't get sick. So if anyone want to help, they can call or email me at willyljeanpauljahoo.com. They can do some donation.
And what's your thoughts on Sean Penn helping with
Haiti? Well, I think Sean Penn is great. I think he should be the president of Haiti just for 4 years. And he would have helped the country, and then after 4 years, he can step down.
Thank you.
That was my dream. Mr. Sean Penn have a piece of my artwork in his house. It's a marketplace.
How?
A gentleman by the name Tripp used to work in a restaurant in Malibu, and he came to a dinner one night as he was leaving to the restaurant, and my friend ran after him to the parking lot and then gave him a piece of artwork. He was a piece of lithograph.
Sean,
yes, he's a marketplace.
He liked it a lot?
He loved it. He said thank you and he left.
That's beautiful.
I swear.
Thank you. So, sir, how you doing?
Hi, Tony.
I hear that this is your event.
Yes, I'm Milton.
Milton what?
Milton Rosenberg, and I'm doing this with Brady Walker this year.
So tell us about it.
It's a free music and art festival. We want to make sure that Venice stays creative and free, so we made a platform for everyone to perform in. So free music, free dance, free art. We'll have a little bit of poetry. We just want to keep Venice alive and vibrant.
How long have you been living in Venice?
I've been here a little over 10, 11 years now, a little over a decade, all on Westminster.
What do you love about Venice?
I love the artists and the creative spirit. I love the fact that I can be me and they don't throw me in jail. I like our town in every way. We have probably 150 people we know in this community, and we're able to do all this for free because of people we know in this community.
What's your thoughts on the decline wave in Venice?
I think that's very sad and scary, and it makes me afraid as a family man, and it concerns me for the future of our town.
How can we stop it?
I think everyone working together, everyone being a neighbor, everyone speaking up when they see something that's wrong, everyone working together can keep our neighborhood safe.
There's a rumor that Daryl Hall, Hall Oates, the son, is playing here today.
No, that's not a rumor, that's a fact. He'll be on stage with Michael Jost and friends today.
How'd that come to be?
This is a very creative community. We know lots of people. We've had all kinds of famous folks that have been through our stage in the past. We've had Fishbone on stage. We've had Tracy Guns on stage. I almost had Donovan here, but his visa didn't come through. But I spoke to his son earlier today, and he was going to come if he was here in the country.
So nobody,
people don't want this stage.
So no one,
we are.
So no one can pay for this.
We pay the city for a permit. We pay the stage and the sound. But the whole thing is done as a nonprofit, and I'm working on getting a 501c3 started in my daughter's name. And it'll be called the Delilah Rose Music and Arts Foundation. And the goal of the foundation is together we can keep music and the arts vibrant for future communities.
So this could be any year.
Yes, we've been doing it for 6 years and we're going to keep going. When you asked about famous people, here's one of my buddies right now, Andy Kravitz. Is going on.
I do.
Andy has baseball cap. Andy has a bunch of gold records, platinum records.
He is.
And there's a lot of famous folks
hiding all over this audience today.
Is he playing today?
Yes, he'll be on stage with Michael Jost and Daryl Hall's son that you were asking about. He's another one of the guests.
And what's your website?
VeniceBeachMusicFest.com, but it got hacked. So for right now, we're using Facebook.com/VeniceBeachMusicFest. So just use Facebook.com/VeniceBeachMusicFest and you'll find us.
Okay, so if some of you are at home and I want to get involved next year, what do I do?
You look at the website. There's the Venice Spring Fling that's coming up in May of 2012. You click on discussion topics and it says what to do if you're a band, it says what to do if you're an artist, it says what to do if you want to vend. So it's open to everybody. Most important, we need the community support to keep them going.
And what's your phone number, sir?
310-450-0031. But I got a 5-week-old baby at home, so send me an email at venicebeachmusicfest@gmail.com.
Well, thank you, man.
Are you ready for this? Ready? Steve, I know you are. When I say yeah, 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 you say yeah, 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 yeah. 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 All right, the next one. It goes like this.
John Oates.
I love John Oates. That's your dad?
It's the other guy. It's the other one. Hall. Hall and Oates.
That's Darryl. What I thought.
Yeah, of course.
How was it growing up with him?
I actually didn't grow up with him. I grew up in Minnesota with my mother.
What happened with that?
My mom was really hot. She was a groupie in the front row in Minneapolis at the Big Bam Boom Tour in 1983. Uh-huh. And then history happened. And here I am.
Why do you feel your father's music has lasted all these years?
It's when it comes down to it, when you have vocal talent like that, he didn't have to be a soul singer, but there is so much soul in it. And it's something that people can always identify with. I mean, the bands that you just have like one-hit wonders, it's like they had a gimmick. His gimmick was he's a talented musician. And if being a musician, if that's your gimmick, you're going to be lasting, you're going to be lasting.
And what name do you go by?
What's that?
What name do you go by?
I go by Hall, Darren Hall. My mom's last name is Zablosky. Darren Zablosky just doesn't have the same ring to it.
You've got to give us a little one-on-one.
A little one-on-one?
Yeah.
What do you mean, like one-on-one? Oh, the song.
Yes.
A little bit of one-on-one, I want to make that dream tonight. There you go.
What's your favorite father song?
Oh, one of his songs? Let's see. I like Sarah Smiles Good. I Can't Go For That's Good. Let's see. Not Kiss Him. What's the You Make My Dreams Come True. That's another good one that Melee did a cover of.
Do you still see your father?
Every once in a while, every couple months.
How is he as a father?
Huh?
How is he as a dad?
As a dad?
Yeah.
He's pretty hands-off. I have to say, I mean, I didn't meet him until I was 18, and then we didn't hang out again until I was 21. And I went on tour with him for 3 years, but I feel like I got to know a lot of the other band members a lot more than him. I mean, he's pretty set in his ways. He has his routine, and that's what he likes to do, so.
Did he marry again?
I believe he is married now. He was never married to my mom, but he is married now to a woman called Amanda Aspinall.
Okay, enough about him, about you now.
Yeah.
I hear you playing today.
I am playing today. I'm playing like an hour.
So who are you playing with? What's it about?
I'm with Michael Jost. He's a local Venice artist. He's been around for maybe 4 or 5 years, down here at least playing music, I know that. I actually think that he started the Venice Beach Music Festival 6 years ago with Milton. And he had a band, Sugar Bitch, and they're not together right now, and now we're doing
my stuff. So we're doing, he's doing a couple of his songs, and then we took a couple of my songs and we reworked them with a full band.
Were you singing your father's songs today?
No. I never sing my father's songs. I don't want to get typecast into that. That can be suicide as an artist. If I start to be identified with just, oh, it's just my father 2.0, I will never be able to get out of that shadow. So you have to have enough separation. I mean, that's his music. I didn't grow up on the streets of Philadelphia in the 60s and the 50s. That wasn't my lifestyle. So I'm not going to try to assume something and take on this mantle of this thing that isn't really who I am. I mean, I grew up, like I said, I was separate from him. I grew up in Minnesota. I have a different thing going. And not that I don't love that music. I love soul, and I can wail. I'm going to wail a little bit today.
You played today, right?
Yeah, oh yeah.
And then you're having an after party up there.
What's that?
You're having an after party later.
Are we?
I got a vibe today.
Oh, are you talking about the one at
yeah.
Michael's?
Yes.
All right.
Well, okay, so thank you.
Absolutely.
Take a leg. We love
I
you.
I will.
About today?
69
huh?
Camaro.
Are you excited?
So I think that it's been a groovy afternoon so far. Does anyone have any anything to say about that? Any contradictions? Everyone have a good time? Relaxing? All right. John, why don't you give me a little bit of music behind me, because I'm going to let that music play for just a second, and then I'm going to introduce the next band who's coming up here in just a second, and they're going to blow your minds. Later on, we've got Trevor Minear, who's a blues act. He's really, really awesome. He's touring the world.
Let's hear it for Michael Jost. Is anyone here? Let's hear it for Michael Jost. He's been playing this show for 6 years. Thank you, Michael.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks, Phil. I'm happy to be here today in Venice. Beautiful as always. Thanks to Milton, thanks to Brady, they made this happen. Peace and love. I have some really amazing people here today. I'm very proud to play with. So we're gonna take it a little bit down. I'm gonna play a couple of my songs, and then later, Andy Kravitz, Samuel Correa, Darren Hall, and Barry Conley gonna play with me. I'm very proud. These are excellent musicians. So I hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much. Thank you.
So what's your thoughts on this festival?
It's outstanding. This is typical Venice. This is the generosity, the beauty of Venice. And when you look around and you see all the different people, different nationalities, different sizes, it doesn't matter. This is what Venice is about.
So where are you from, sir?
You'll see no Venice. You'll see no. Well, I'm in Venice 31 years.
Your name?
I'm Bill. My name is Bill.
And what brought you here?
Yeah. What brought me here was Venice. It was the atmosphere of Venice.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
The Venice Philharmonic Orchestra. Philharmonic means, comes from the Greek, it means something like music lovers. And all these people that are going to be coming up playing with me are definitely music lovers. And this is all what connects us. So I hope this connects us here today too. So one more song before that's going to be called Nuclear Spinach. Mr. Andy Kravitz, incredible drummer, producer on all kinds of like famous projects. I'm very proud to have him on stage today. Incredible drummer. On bass, Sam Correa. I'm always happy to be with this man on stage. These two together are my dream team. And also I introduce you to Goya, my little girl from Sweden, 1958. I love her. So she's gonna play for you a song too. Song's gonna call Bright New Tomorrow. Thank you.
now we beef it up some more. Barry Connolly, an incredible, crazy, very talented, super good man, is coming on stage playing the auto controller drum. Oh, he got a new hairdo for that too. This is a very special instrument. I can't explain it. You will hear it in a moment. It's insane. And acoustic guitar, vocals. We have Darren Hall here today. Really very talented young man. Very happy to have him.
Miles below me, I'm under the mountain of my own complacency. My darkness hides so deep inside my entrance. It's getting hard to know. I'm tired, life is just making me.
on vocals, ladies and gentlemen. The last two songs were his songs. Thank you very much.
Get off my cable.
Get off my cable.
All right, later.
Jerry Con, Barry Conley on out of control.
Holy cow, I think everyone's just as stunned as I am that they're not going to be playing anymore.
What?
Give it up for Michael Jost and friends. My gosh, were they not awesome?
That was it.
Fun, fun, fun.
That was it.
That's it for right now.
They were great.
But we have a couple more fun things coming up for you here in the next couple of minutes.
That was really, really amazing.
I want to have John take some.
I really didn't know you were that good.
I didn't either until I hear a full band with it. That's the first
your
time
father, I've got never on you.
Both of those songs I've only ever heard with acoustic guitar until Tuesday. So it's, I don't. Hold on.
Guys,
we're
very good. Do you have any
CDs? We start the band on Tuesday.
You're kidding me.
We're playing together. This is our second time playing together.
This is the closest I heard to Pink Floyd. This is very amazing, wasn't
awesome
it?
To hear.
Very amazing. Very good. What's the name of your band?
The Venice Philharmonic with the music lovers, Philos, right?
Okay.
We love harmony.
Yeah.
Next step is to record something, so hopefully in the next month
hopefully
or so.
Okay. Very, very good.
Thank you.
Very congratulations.
You know who his father is, right?
No.
No doubt. Hall Oates?
No, I don't.
He's a big lady.
Oh, okay.
His dad's like Daryl Hall.
Oh, okay.
Edison from Venice Paparazzi.
Good job out there. Thank you.
Your father would be proud.
I think so. Maybe we'll send him the tape.
So what's the name of the group?
We're the Venice Beach Philharmonic.
Well, you guys are definitely going to go all places. You get a copy, get this coming, no problem.
Yeah, we're gonna get a copy of this. We're gonna get in the studio and start recording stuff. That was,
no, you guys are gonna be big, man. Because like I said, I think that was the piece they needed was you.
And they need some vocals. Michael needs some driving vocals. His guitar is so powerful. He has to have somebody that can.
Well, he had that sugar bitch.
Yeah.
But that didn't work out with him. But it worked out because he got you now.
Right.
You're proud of me, proud of you. Really.
Yeah. He's never even heard me sing. He's nothing. So.
You want to say anything to him?
Hopefully this will be. I'm coming.
Cool.
It'll be live from Daryl's house, right? You'll have me on.
Oh, it's so much fun.
Hey.
That was awesome.
Good job.
What do you think about stuff with the full band? Right?
Yeah.
Like, you foolish boy, bro.
Yeah, dude. That sounded really good.
Well, that's only two. We only rehearsed twice.
Shit.
Wow. Yeah. We met on Tuesday. I ran the gig. Friday.
Yeah. Hey, Michael, I was amazed. No, seriously, come over here. Really, man, I was amazed because Sugar Bitch was a big part of your band. She's not there anymore. And you got the man yourself.
It's different. It's not Sugar Bitch. It's a different thing of mine. You know?
I know, but this is like, listen, I'm not blowing smoke up your ass. Yes. You got the sound, man. It's fucking, it's like magic, man.
It's a little different, right?
No, but I can see what you've been creating, man.
Yes.
It's really fucking good, dude.
Thank you so much.
Seriously, man.
Hey, I come back to you in a second. They have my really expensive guitars up there.
420, right?
At 420 meter.
Okay.
You should have some.
Amazing, dude.
Hey, brother.
Let me say amazing, man.
Oh, man, thank you.
What's your name, sir?
Andy.
And you guys are new together, right?
Yep.
How's it feel to play with Daryl Hall's son?
That's amazing. I mean, you know, his dad is such a legend, and I'm from Philly, so Hall and Oates being from Philly, it's like
Philly?
Your hometown boy, yeah.
Me too. I was born in Philly.
No kidding. Where at?
Okay, a question
awesome
for you.
Okay.
Who's your brother? Your favorite yourself?
Well, man, you know, I like it all, man. I like, you know, I like great music and so much, you know, so much out there. Taj Mahal, Los Lobos, you know, there's so much great music happening right now. All the kids coming up.
I got lost in your music, man. It was amazing. When I did video, mm-hmm. I had to feel it. And I felt it. And I feel that the video's all going to be good.
Dude, oh, that's wonderful, man. That makes my day.
I want to shake your hand. I'm not blowing up your ass, man. It's fucking amazing, man. Seriously.
Brother, thank you, man. That felt really good, man.
Outstanding.
What a show. What a stage, you know.
Oh,
the world.
Unbelievable.
A guitarist and songwriter. He just moved here from
Chicago. Sir, sorry. Sir.
Amazing. No, amazing. All you guys together. You got Daryl Hall, son, yourself, Michael, amazing.
We just, I can't explain it.
No, but it's just like amazing, man. And you get me, when I do video, I got to feel it. The video's better. I was into it, man.
Oh, you felt the right off the back. Thank you, man.
I'm not blowing it. It's unbelievable, man. This you're going to be famous. So,
thank you.
What's your name, please, sir?
Sam Correa.
And you? Tony Bearer.
Tony, thank you, man.
You get a website.
Appreciate it. No, I don't have, but Michael and Facebook, he has some stuff in Facebook.
Okay, man.
I'm all over the place myself.
Keep it up, man. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You're the fucking shit, man. You are a god on this. Just vibing. Thank you so much.
We appreciate that.
It's unbelievable, man.
Seriously. Micah knows how to put together a nice one.
Hey, thank you very much.
Where's Sam? Where's Barry?
Barry! Don't get undressed yet!
Barry's looking good. Hey, Edison. Edison from Venice Paparazzi here. Hi, Tony.
Hi, Edison.
What's
this?
At Hall & Oates. I used to work merch at Hall & Oates, and they came up and I was selling CDs, and I was very nice, they were very nice, and we went out and had a drink. Which venue was it?
It was Agua Caliente.
Agua Caliente, that's right.
Whatever.
Isn't it great?
Agua Caliente.
I know, I love it.
My dad and Sly were very good friends in Philadelphia, right when he was coming up, and he was a boxer, and he's like, yo, Daryl, you know, Daryl, I want to make this movie, man. I want to make this movie, and I think you could do maybe this theme music for me, you know. He says, we can do the theme song, and my dad's like, oh, what? Who's this guy that's, you know, punching the head too many times? So he kind of goes, whatever, whatever. Well, the movie was Rocky, and the soundtrack, of course, you know, the theme song to Rocky is, so now, apparently, every time my dad sees Sylvester, he goes, hey, Daryl, should have done that movie, huh? You should have done that movie. It's one of the things he says he kicks himself now. He said he could write a book on all the mistakes you make, and then you get to look back. But he could have been Eye of the Tiger, could have been a Hall & Oates.
Welcome. Thank you, though. Have a great day. Very big situation we're going to talk about tonight, folks. So I want you to gather around. I don't bite. It doesn't bite. When I was a kid, it was bigger than me. So with your help, we could get through this together.
What's your name?
David.
And what brings you out here today?
Just to make people laugh.
Why do you love Venice so much?
Because you're allowed to be free, crazy. You get to smoke weed as long as you keep your medical marijuana card. It's not that much, you know? And you get to enjoy yourself as long as you're not doing nothing illegal.
And how long have you been coming to Venice?
Oh yeah, and keep your alcohol in a styrofoam container.
Correct. And how long have you been coming to Venice?
For about 5 years now.
Very good, sir. Keep up the good work.
Thank you so much.
How do you know how to do this?
From a guy named Tony Vera.
You seriously? What did Tony Vera do?
He balanced the lady on a chair on his chin.
So you basically, how'd you learn it though?
I just tried a broom first and then worked my way up.
And then, how much weight are you doing now?
About 85 pounds.
So this is a heavy metal object?
Yeah, this is about 65.
And you can do that?
Yeah.
Well, show it to me. That's amazing, man. So what do you got? So what do you guys do here? This is your store?
Yeah, we're working. Skate shop.
Take me around. Show me.
We work at the skate shop where the show was once performed. It's called Venice Skateboarding Stuff.
Right.
And I'm here all day.
So what do you sell?
A bunch of skateboards.
And you guys have all the top stuff in here?
Yeah, of course. Top of the line, everything we have.
What do we need? Your website?
Yes, the website's VeniceSkateboardingStuff.com.
Spell it?
Venice Skateboarding Stuff.
And this is your second store, right?
Yes, the second one.
Where is the second store located?
The other one is down the boardwalk about a good 5 blocks away.
And your name?
Kevin.
And your name?
Ruby.
And who are you?
I'm his sister.
Okay, how long have you guys been in business?
14 years.
Okay, man, thank you. So, you've had this store for how many years?
15 years. It's a family business.
Why did you pick skateboarding?
Why? Because I like skateboarding.
And do you have a big following that come to see you? Like, do you have like people all over the world that order from your store?
A lot of people.
Because there was one guy, he was buying like 1,000 pair of shoes.
Yes, it is.
Is he still doing that?
Yes, it is.
And what's your website?
My website is Venice Skateboarding Stuff.
And your name?
My name is Ruben.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Hello, Tony. This is Kevin.
Oh, that's amazing, man. Oh, joy. Jesus.
That's a 12-foot ladder.
Oh, man. Oh, that's a 12-foot ladder?
Yeah.
God, man. So, do you plan on being a balancer out here?
Maybe. I thought about it.
Have you done about fire too, or not yet?
Fire is a little hard. I've tried I tried a little bit. I'm not very good at it.
No, I'll give you some pointers, man. You gotta start. I gotta say it on camera. You get up there.
Hello, Tony. This is Kevin.
Oh, that's amazing, man. Oh, joy. Jesus.
That's a 12-foot ladder.
Oh, man. Oh, that's a 12-foot ladder?
Yeah.
God, man. So, do you plan on being a balancer out here?
Maybe. I thought about it.
Have you done about fire too, or not yet?
Fire is a little hard. I've tried I tried a little bit, and I'm not very good at it.
No, I'll give you some pointers, man. You gotta start. I gotta stand on camera.
What? After Monday, all this is coming off.
Why?
Gotta fit my passport. All this shit ain't on my passport. Yeah. I gotta cut it all off.
Oh, I think that's gonna be strange.
Be different, that's all. People have to get used to seeing me like this for a while anyway. I might keep it like that.
Wow.
Yeah, who knows?